Astor Piazzolla. Astor Pantaleón Piazzolla was an Argentine tango composer, bandoneon player, and arranger. His oeuvre revolutionized the traditional tango into a new style termed nuevo tango, incorporating elements from jazz and classical music. A virtuoso bandoneonist, he regularly performed his own compositions with a variety of ensembles. In 1992, American music critic Stephen Holden described Piazzolla as the world's foremost composer of tango music. Piazzolla was born in Mar del Plata, Argentina, in 1921, the only child of Italian immigrant parents, Vicente Nonino Piazzolla and Assunta Manetti. His paternal grandfather, a sailor and fisherman named Pantaleo Piazzolla, had immigrated to Mar del Plata from Trani, a seaport in the southeastern Italian region of Apulia, at the end of the 19th century. His mother was the daughter of two Italian immigrants from Lucca in Tuscany. In 1925, Astor Piazzolla moved with his family to Greenwich Village in New York City, which in those days was a violent neighborhood inhabited by a volatile mixture of gangsters and hard-working immigrants. His parents worked long hours and Piazzolla soon learned to take care of himself on the streets despite having a limp. At home he would listen to his father's records of the tango orchestras of Carlos Gardel and Julio De Caro, and was exposed to jazz and classical music, including Bach, from an early age. He began to play the bandoneon after his father spotted one in a New York pawn shop in 1929. After their return to New York City from a brief visit to Mar del Plata in 1930, the family moved to Little Italy in Lower Manhattan. In 1932 Piazzolla composed his first tango, La Cachinca. The following year he took music lessons with the Hungarian classical pianist Béla Wilda, a student of Rachmaninoff who taught him to play Bach on his bandoneon. In 1934 he met Carlos Gardel, one of the most important figures in the history of tango, and played a cameo role as a paperboy in his movie El Día Que Me Quieras. Gardel invited the young bandoneon player to join him on his tour. Much to Piazzolla's dismay, his father decided that he was not old enough to go along. The disappointment of being forbidden to join the tour proved to be fortunate, as it was on this tour in 1935 that Gardel and his entire orchestra perished in a plane crash. In later years, Piazzolla made light of this near miss, joking that if his father had not been so careful, Piazzolla would be playing the harp rather than the bandoneon. In 1936, he returned with his family to Mar del Plata, where he began to play in a variety of tango orchestras, and around this time he discovered the music of Elvino Vardaro's sextet on the radio. Vardaro's novel interpretation of tango made a great impression on Piazzolla, and years later he would become Piazzolla's violinist in his Orquesta de Cuerdas and his first quintet. Inspired by Vardaro's style of tango, and still only 17 years old, Piazzolla moved to Buenos Aires in 1938 where, the following year, he realized a dream when joined the orchestra of the bandoneonist Aníbal Troilo, which would become one of the greatest tango orchestras of that time. Piazzolla was employed as a temporary replacement for Toto Rodriguez, who was ill, but when Rodriguez returned to work Troilo decided to retain Piazzolla as a fourth bandoneonist. Apart from playing the bandoneon, Piazzolla also became Troilo's arranger and would occasionally play the piano for him. By 1941 he was earning a good wage, enough to pay for music lessons with Alberto Ginastera, an eminent Argentine composer of classical music. It was the pianist Arthur Rubinstein, then living in Buenos Aires, who had advised him to study with Ginastera and delving into scores of Stravinsky, Bartok, Ravel, and others. Piazzolla rose early each morning to hear the Teatro Colón orchestra rehearse while continuing a grueling performing schedule in the tango clubs at night. During his 5 years of study with Ginastera he mastered orchestration, which he later considered to be one of his strong points. In 1943 he started piano lessons with the Argentine classical pianist Raúl Spivak, which would continue for the next 5 years, and wrote his first classical works Preludio No. 1 for violin and piano and Suite for strings and harps. That same year he married his first wife, Dede Wolf, an artist, with whom he had two children, Diana and Daniel. As time went by Troilo began to fear that the advanced musical ideas of the young bandoneonist might undermine the style of his orchestra and make it less appealing to dancers of tango. Tensions mounted between the two bandoneonists until, in 1944, Piazzolla announced his intention to leave Troilo and join the orchestra of the tango singer and bandoneonist Francisco Fiorentino. Piazzolla would lead Fiorentino's orchestra until 1946 and make many recordings with him, including his first two instrumental tangos, La Chiflada and Color de Rosa. In 1946 Piazzolla formed his Orquesta Tipica, which, although having a similar formation to other tango orchestras of the day, gave him his first opportunity to experiment with his own approach to the orchestration and musical content of tango. That same year he composed El Desfonde, which he considered to be his first formal tango, and then began to compose musical scores for films, starting with Con los mismos colores in 1949 and Bolidos de Cero in 1950, both films directed by Carlos Torres Rias. Having disbanded his first orchestra in 1950, he almost abandoned tango altogether as he continued to study Bartok and Stravinsky in orchestra direction with Hermann Scherchen. He spent a lot of time listening to jazz and searching for a musical style of his own beyond the realms of tango. He decided to drop the bandoneon and to dedicate himself to writing and to studying music. Between 1950 and 1954 he composed a series of works that began to develop his unique style: Paralucirse, Tanguango, Preparence, Contrabajeando, Triunfal and Lo que vendrá. At Inestera's urging, on August 16, 1953, Piazzolla entered his classical composition Buenos Aires Symphony in three movements for the Fabian Savitsky Award. The performance took place at the Law School in Buenos Aires with the Symphony Orchestra of Radio del Estado under the direction of Savitsky himself. At the end of the concert, a fight broke out among members of the audience who were offended by the inclusion of two bandoneons in a traditional symphony orchestra. In spite of this, Piazzolla's composition won a grant from the French government to study in Paris with the legendary French composition teacher Nadia Boulanger at the Fontainebleau Conservatory. In 1954 he and his wife left their two children with Piazzolla's parents and traveled to Paris. Piazzolla was tired of tango and tried to hide his tangero past and his bandoneon compositions from Boulanger, thinking that his destiny lay in classical music. Introducing his work, Piazzolla played her a number of his classically inspired compositions, but it was not until he played his tango Triunfal that she congratulated him and encouraged him to pursue his career in tango, recognizing that this was where his talent lay. This was to prove a historic encounter and a crossroad in Piazzolla's career. With Boulanger he studied classical composition, including counterpoint, which was to play an important role in his later tango compositions. Before leaving Paris, he heard the octet of the American jazz saxophonist Jerry Mulligan, which was to give him the idea of forming his own octet on his return to Buenos Aires. He composed and recorded a series of tangos with the string orchestra of the Paris Opera and began to play the bandoneon while standing up, putting his right foot on a chair and the bellows of the instrument across his right thigh. Until that time, bandoneonists played sitting down. Back in Argentina, Piazzolla formed his Orquesta de Cuerdas, which performed with the singer Jorge Sobral, and his Octeto Buenos Aires in 1955. With two bandoneons, two violins, double bass, cello, piano, and an electric guitar, his octeto effectively broke the mold of the traditional orquesta típica and created a new sound akin to chamber music, without a singer and with jazz-like improvisations. This was to be a turning point in his career and a watershed in the history of tango. Piazzolla's new approach to the tango, nuevo tango, made him a controversial figure in his native land both musically and politically. However, his music gained acceptance in Europe and North America, and his reworking of the tango was embraced by some liberal segments of Argentine society, who were pushing for political changes in parallel to his musical revolution. In 1958 he disbanded both the octeto and the string orchestra and returned to New York City with his family, where he struggled to make a living as a musician and arranger. Briefly forming his own group, the Jazz Tango Quintet, with whom he made just two recordings, his attempts to blend jazz and tango were not successful. He received the news of the death of his father in October 1959 while performing with Juan Carlos Copes and Maria Nieves in Puerto Rico, and on his return to New York City a few days later, he asked to be left alone in his apartment and in less than an hour wrote his famous tango Adios Nonino, in homage to his father. Copes and Nieves packed out Club Flamboyant in San Juan, Puerto Rico with Compañía Argentina Tangolandia. Piazzolla was serving as the musical director. The tour continued in New York, Chicago and then Washington. The last show that the three of them did together was an appearance on CBS, the only colored channel in the U.S., on the Arthur Murray Show in April 1960. Back in Buenos Aires later that year he put together the first, and perhaps most famous, of his quintets, the first quinteto, initially comprising bandoneon, piano, violin, electric guitar and double bass. Of the many ensembles that Piazzolla set up during his career, it was the quintet formation which best expressed his approach to tango. In 1963 he set up his Nuevo Octeto and the same year premiered his Tres Tangos Sinfónicos, under the direction of Paul Klecki, for which he was awarded the Hirsch Prize. In 1965 he released El Tango, an album for which he collaborated with the Argentine writer Jorge Luis Borges. The recording featured his quinteto together with an orchestra, the singer Edmundo Rivero and Luis Medina Castro reciting texts. In 1966 he left the Day Wolf and the following year signed a 5-year contract with the poet Horacio Ferrer, with whom he composed the operetta Maria de Buenos Aires, with lyrics by Ferrer. The work was premiered in May 1968 with the singer Amelita Baltar in the title role and introduced a new style of tango, tango canción. Soon after this he began a relationship with Amelita Baltar. The following year he wrote Balada para un Loco with lyrics by Ferrer, which was premiered at the first Ibero-American Music Festival with Amelita Baltar and Piazzolla himself conducting the orchestra. Piazzolla was awarded second prize and the composition would prove to be his first popular success. In 1970 Piazzolla returned to Paris where with Ferrer he wrote the oratorio El Pueblo Joven, later premiered in Saarbrücken, Germany in 1971. On May 19, 1970 he gave a concert with his quinteto at the Teatro Regina in Buenos Aires in which he premiered his composition Cuatro Estaciones Porteñas. Back in Buenos Aires he founded his Conjunto 9, a chamber music formation, which was a realization of a dream for Piazzolla and for which composed some of his most sophisticated music. He now put aside his first quinteto and made several recordings with his new ensemble in Italy. Within a year the Conjunto 9 had run into financial problems and was dissolved, and in 1972 he participated in his first concert at the Teatro Colón in Buenos Aires, sharing the bill with other tango orchestras. After a period of great productivity as a composer, he suffered a heart attack in 1973, and that same year he moved to Italy where he began a series of recordings which would span a period of 5 years. The music publisher Aldo Pagani, a partner in Curci Pagani Music, had offered Piazzolla a 15-year contract in Romita record anything he could write. His famous album Liber Tango was recorded in Milan in May 1974, and later that year he separated from Amelita Baltar and in September recorded the album Summit with the saxophonist Jerry Mulligan and an Italian orchestra, including jazz musicians such as bassist/arranger Pino Presti and drummer Tullio De Piscopo, in Milan. The album includes the composition Air de Buenos Aires by Mulligan. In 1975 he set up his electronic octet, an octet made up of bandoneon, electric piano and or acoustic piano, organ, guitar, electric bass, drums, synthesizer and violin, which was later replaced by a flute or saxophone. Later that year Annibale Troilo died and Piazzolla composed the suite Troiliana in his memory, a work in 4 parts, which he recorded with the Conjunto Electronico. At this time Piazzolla started a collaboration with the singer José Atreus, with whom he made a number of recordings. In December 1976 he played at a concert at the Teatro Gran Rex in Buenos Aires, where he presented his work, 500 Motivaciones, written especially for the Conjunto Electronico, and in 1977 he played another memorable concert at the Olympia in Paris, with the new formation of the Conjunto Electronico. In 1978 he formed his second quintet, with which he would tour the world for 11 years, and would make him world-renowned. He also returned to writing chamber music and symphonic works. During the period of Argentine military dictatorship from 1976 to 1983, Piazzolla lived in Italy, but returned many times to Argentina, recorded there, and on at least one occasion had lunch with the dictator Jorge Rafael Videla. However, his relationship with the dictator might have been less than friendly, as recounted in Astor Piazzolla, A Manera de Memorias. In 1995 his family received the Conex Award, as the most important musician of the decade in Argentina. In 1982 he recorded the album Oblivion with an orchestra in Italy for the film Enrico IV, directed by Marco Bellocchio, and in May 1982, in the middle of the Falklands War, he played in a concert at the Teatro Regina, Buenos Aires with the second quinteto and the singer Roberto Goyeneche. That same year he wrote La Gran Tango for cello and piano, dedicated to Russian cellist, Mstislav Rostropovich, which would be premiered by him in 1990 Inches, New Orleans. guests. On June 11, 1983, he put on one of the best concerts of his life when he played a program of his music at the Teatro Colón in Buenos Aires. For the occasion, he regrouped the Conjunto 9 and played solo with the Buenos Aires Philharmonic, directed by Pedro Ignacio Calderón. The program included his three-movement concerto para bandoneon y orquesta and his three-movement concerto de nácar. On July 4, 1984, Piazzolla appeared with his quinteto at the Montreal International Jazz Festival, the world's largest jazz festival, and on 29 September that same year they appeared with the Italian singer Milva at the Théâtre des Bouffes du Nord, Paris. His concert on October 15, 1984 at the Teatro Nazionale in Milan was recorded and released as the album Suite Punt dell'Est. At the end of that same year he performed in West Berlin, and in Theater Vredenburg in Utrecht, in the Netherlands, where VPRO-TV director Theo Uitenbogaard recorded his quinteto Tango Nuevo, playing, among other pieces, a very moving Adios Nonino, with as a backdrop, to Piazzolla's great pleasure, the extremely zoomed-in live projection of his bandoneon playing. In 1985 he was named illustrious citizen of Buenos Aires and premiered his concerto for bandoneon and guitar, at the 5th International Liège Guitar Festival on March 15, with the Liège Philharmonic Orchestra conducted by Leo Brouwer and Cacho Durão on guitar. Piazzolla made his London debut with his second quinteto at the Almeida Theatre in London at the end of June. With a film score for El Exilio de Gardel, he won the French Critics César Award in Paris for Best Film Music in 1986. He appeared at the Montreux Jazz Festival, Montreux, Switzerland, with vibraphonist Gary Burton in July 1986 and on September 6, 1987 gave a concert in New York's Central Park, in the city where he spent his childhood. In September 1987 he recorded his concerto para bandoneon y orquesta and Tres Tangos para bandoneon y orquesta with Lalo Schifrin conducting the SD Luke's Orchestra, in the Richardson Auditorium at Princeton University. In 1988 he wrote music for the film Sir and married the singer and television personality Laura Escalada on April 11. In May that year he recorded his album Lacamora in New York, a suite of three pieces, the last time he would record with the second quinteto. During a tour of Japan with Milva he played at a concert at the Nakano-san Plaza Hall in Tokyo on June 26, 1988 and that same year underwent a quadruple bypass operation. Early in 1989 he formed his Sexteto Nuevo Tango, his last ensemble, with two bandoneons, piano, electric guitar, bass and cello. Together they gave a concert at the Club Italiano in Buenos Aires in April, a recording of which was issued under the title of Tres Minutos con la Realidad. Later he appeared with them at the Teatro Opera in Buenos Aires in the presence of the newly elected Argentine President Carlos Menem on Friday, June 9. This would be Piazzolla's last concert in Argentina. There followed a concert at the Royal Carré Theatre in Amsterdam with his Sexteto and Osvaldo Pugliese's Orchestra on June 26, 1989, a live recording at the BK Bristol Studios in June 1989, between concerts in Berlin and Rome, and a concert at the Wembley Conference Centre on June 30, 1989. On November 4, 1989, he gave a concert in Lausanne, Switzerland, at the Milano Danse, and later that month he recorded his composition Five Tango Sensations, with the Kronos Quartet in the U.S. on an album of the same name. This would be his last studio recording and was his second composition for the Kronos Quartet. His first four tango had been included in their 1988 album Winter Was Hard. Towards the end of the year he dissolved his sexteto and continued playing solo with classical string quartets and symphonic orchestras. He joined Anna E. Carfi's Mandova String Quartet and toured Italy and Finland with them. His 1982 composition, Le Grand Tango, for cello and piano was premiered in New Orleans by the Russian cellist Mstislav Rostropovich and the pianist Igor Ryash in 1990, and on July 3 he gave his last concert in Athens, Greece, with the Athens Orchestra of Colors, conducted by Manos Hatzidakis. He suffered a cerebral hemorrhage in Paris on August 4, 1990. Which left him in a coma, and died in Buenos Aires, just under 2 years later on July 4, 1992, without regaining consciousness. Among his followers, the composer and pianist Fernando Otero and Piazzolla's protégé, bandoneonist Marcelo Nisinman, are the best-known innovators of tango music of the new millennium, while Pablo Ziegler, pianist with Piazzolla's second quintet, has assumed the role of principal custodian of Nuevo Tango, extending the jazz influence in the style. The Brazilian guitarist Sergio Assad has also experimented with folk-derived, complex virtuoso compositions that show Piazzolla's structural influence while steering clear of tango sounds, and Osvaldo Galihoff has acknowledged Piazzolla as perhaps the greatest influence in his globally oriented, eclectic compositions for classical and klezmer performers. Piazzolla's nuevo tango was distinct from the traditional tango in its incorporation of elements of jazz, its use of extended harmonies and dissonance, its use of counterpoint, and its ventures into extended compositional forms. As Argentine psychoanalyst Carlos Curry has pointed out, Piazzolla's fusion of tango with this wide range of other recognizable Western musical elements was so successful that it produced a new individual style transcending these influences. It is precisely this success and individuality that makes it hard to pin down where particular influences reside in his compositions, but some aspects are clear. The use of the passacaglia technique of a circulating bass line and harmonic sequence, invented and much used in 17th and 18th century Baroque music, but also central to the idea of jazz changes, predominates in most of Piazzolla's mature compositions. Another clear reference to the Baroque is the often complex and virtuosic counterpoint that sometimes follows strict fugal behavior but more often simply allows each performer in the group to assert his voice. A further technique that emphasizes this sense of democracy and freedom among the musicians is improvisation, that is borrowed from jazz in concept, but in practice involves a different vocabulary of scales and rhythms that stay within the parameters of the established tango sound world. Pablo Ziegler has been particularly responsible for developing this aspect of the style both within Piazzolla's groups and since the composer's death. With the composition of Adios Nonino in 1959, Piazzolla established a standard structural pattern for his compositions, involving a formal pattern of fast-slow-fast-slow coa, with the fast sections emphasizing gritty tango rhythms and harsh, angular melodic figures, and the slower sections usually making use of the string instrument in the group and or Piazzolla's own bandoneon as lyrical soloists. The piano tends to be used throughout as a percussive rhythmic backbone, while the electric guitar either joins in this role or spins filigree improvisations. The double bass parts are usually of little interest, but provide an indispensable rug thickness to the sound of the ensemble. The quintet of bandoneon, violin, piano, electric guitar and double bass was Piazzolla's preferred setup on two extended occasions during his career, and most critics consider it to be the most successful instrumentation for his works. This is due partly to its great efficiency in terms of sound. It covers or imitates most sections of a symphony orchestra, including the percussion, which is improvised by all players on the bodies of their instruments, and the strong expressive identity it permits each individual musician. With a style that is both rugged and intricate, such a setup augments the composition's inherent characteristics. Despite the prevalence of the quintet formation and the ABAPC compositional structure, Piazzolla consistently experimented with other musical forms and instrumental combinations. In 1965, an album was released containing collaborations between Piazzolla and Jorge Luis Borges, where Borges's poetry was narrated over very avant-garde music by Piazzolla, including the use of dodecaphonic rows, free non-melodic improvisation on all instruments, and modal harmonies and scales. In 1968, Piazzolla wrote and produced an operetta, Maria de Buenos Aires, that employed a larger ensemble including flute, percussion, multiple strings and three vocalists, and juxtaposed movements in Piazzolla's own style with several pastiche numbers ranging from waltz on hurdy-gurdy to a piano-slash-narrator barroom scene straight out of Casablanca. By the 1970s, Piazzolla was living in Rome, managed by the Italian agent Aldo Pagani, and exploring a leaner, more fluid musical style drawing on more jazz influence, and with simpler, more continuous forms. Pieces that exemplify this new direction include Liber Tango and Most of the Suite Royaliana, written in memory of Anibal Troilo. In the 1980s, Piazzolla was wealthy enough, for the first time, to become relatively autonomous artistically, and wrote some of his most ambitious multi-movement works. These included Tango Suite for the virtuoso guitar duo Sergio and Odair Assad, Historia Tango, where a flutist and guitarist tell the history of tango in four chunks of music styled at 30-year intervals, and La Camorra, a suite in three 10-minute movements, inspired by the Neapolitan crime family and exploring symphonic concepts of large-scale form, thematic development, contrasts of texture and massive accumulations of ensemble sound. After making three albums in New York with the second quintet and producer Kip Hanrahan, two of which he described on separate occasions as the greatest thing I've done, he disbanded the quintet, formed a sextet with an extra bandoneon, cello, bass, electric guitar, and piano, and wrote music for this ensemble that was even more adventurous harmonically and structurally than any of his previous works. Had he not suffered an incapacitating stroke on the way to Notre Dame Mass in 1990, it is likely that he would have continued to use his popularity as a performer of his own works to experiment in relative safety with even more audacious musical techniques, while possibly responding to the surging popularity of non-Western musics by finding ways to incorporate new styles into his own. In his musical professionalism and open-minded attitude to existing styles, he held the mindset of an 18th-century composing performer such as Handel or Mozart, who were anxious to assimilate all national flavors of their day into their own compositions, and who always wrote with both first-hand performing experience and a sense of direct social relationship with their audiences. This may have resulted in a backlash amongst conservative tango aficionados in Argentina, but in the rest of the West it was the key to his extremely sympathetic reception among classical and jazz musicians, both seeing some of the best aspects of their musical practices reflected in his work. After leaving Troilo's orchestra in the 1940s, Piazzolla led numerous ensembles beginning with the 1946 orchestra, the 1955 Octeto Buenos Aires, the 1961 quintet, the 1971 Conjunto 9, the 1978 Second Quintet and the 1989 New Tango Sextet. As well as providing original compositions and arrangements, he was the director and bandoneon player in all of them. He also recorded the album Summit with jazz baritone saxophonist Jerry Mulligan. His numerous compositions include orchestral work such as the Concerto para Bandoneon, Orquesta, Cuerdas y Percusión, Doble Concerto para Bandoneon y Guitarra, Tres Tangos Sinfónicos and Concierto Nacar para Nightingistas y Orquesta, pieces for the solo classical guitar, the Cinco Piezas, as well as song-form compositions that still today are well known by the general public in his country, including Balada para un Loco and Adios Nonino, which he recorded many times with different musicians and ensembles. Biographers estimate that Piazzolla wrote around 3,000 pieces and recorded around 500. In 1984 he appeared with his Quinteto Tango Nuevo in West Berlin, Germany and for television in Utrecht, Netherlands. In the summer of 1985 he performed at the Almeida Theatre in London for a week-long engagement. On September 6, 1987, his quintet gave a concert in New York's Central Park, which was recorded and, in 1994, released in compact disc format as the Central Park Concert. Thanks for watching. Don't forget like the video and don't forget to subscribe.